Thanks, John. The Boston Marathon is tomorrow here in Boston, but the Stanley Cup Playoff Marathon kicks off tonight between the Bruins and the Sabres. Each marathon equally grueling. Time now for a look at the starting goaltenders, brought to you by Thrifty, the official car rental company of the NHL. Grant Fuhr, Mr. Playoff, he has been known as throughout his career. We'll see if he can spark a little bit of magic for the Buffalo Sabres. It's been a long time since they've had a money goaltender in the playoffs. And at the other end, Andy Moog, who has been absolutely sensational. He has played in the last 54 Boston Bruins postseason games. You know he's going to see the lion's share of action all the way through this year. The referee is Don Koharski. On the line, Swede Knox and Brad Lazarowicz. Ray Bourque will pump it down and on goal. And the playoffs underway at the Garden. Great to have you with us. Grant Ledyard lugging the puck up to center for the Sabres. Area was tightroping along the line trying to come in. And Alexander Mogilny out there, front and center, number 89. Here's Poulin, wrapped up along the boards, twisted down to the ice by Airy. And Koharski right on top of things, right off the bat. You'll see a lot of this. It's going to be a tough series.
Well, Brian Sutter gets the last line change here tonight. And you just know that he's got the opportunity to do a lot of anything that the Buffalo Sabres want to do. But he's flying very early in this game. Mogilny going to the penalty box for that trip.
Gary, talking to both coaches earlier during the skates today and just before the game, Sutter extremely confident, and his counterpart John Muckler almost defensive about his team's past history in the playoffs.
Well, I think that John Muckler is right. A lot of these Buffalo Sabres didn't have anything to do with the past.
And yet it hangs over them like a sword, and they wear it around their necks like a millstone. The Sabres have not won a playoff series in 10 years. They beat the Montreal Canadiens in three straight all the way back in the 1983 playoff season. And then they were beaten out by the Boston Bruins. Ray Bourque was on that Boston team, and he lugs the puck up to center. Moves it up on the wing now. Wesley trying to dance his way in. Here's Bourque. Juno. Down low. Neely's in front. 1:17 to go on the power play. Neely, watch closely. Juno punches one just wide. And it's finally zipped down the ice by Colin Patterson. 1 minute, 5 seconds to go on the man advantage for the Boston Bruins. We are just underway, 0-0 hockey game. Four. Neely and Juno up there with him.
Presley, one of the best penalty killers for the Buffalo Sabres, likes to force in deep. That's what he was doing on that last shift.
Here comes Neely trying to barge his way through, but the door was closed up before he could make it through. Bourque will wing it around the boards. 42 seconds to go on the power play. Fuhr up to Presley. And he had just enough room to get it down the ice with 34 seconds to go on the man advantage. Bruins will make some line changes on the fly. Bourque gets it up ahead. Leach trying to come in. He finds the sledding pretty tough against Grant Ledyard. Shaw moving in from the point. Trying to chop it loose up there with Oates. Bartolnov going after it. Ledyard heads him off at the pass and gets the puck up over the boards. And 9 seconds now remaining in the man advantage for Boston.
John Muckler's team have got some pretty good things going for them. One of them is penalty killing. The third best in the National Hockey League. John Muckler has gone to, well, some revisions to play against the Boston Bruins. I guess he had to. They lost those last four games. But yet, John Muckler didn't feel that in the last part of the season that his team played that poorly. The last seven games, when they didn't win, he still felt that they played reasonably well. Look at those last two games against the Boston Bruins, for example. Post games, 3-0, 3-2.
And we're seeing a good example here of what did go well for the Sabres this year, and that's penalty killing, Gary. It was the third best in the league. Sweeney knocked away. Cannon will charge up after it, but won't get there nearly in time. Moog gives it away. Incredible. Incredible! Unbelievable!
Gabe Hannon can't believe what he got. A gift. Andy Moog goes to play it. He went to sweep it around behind the net. Instead, it ends up hitting the side of the net, and Dave Hannon just breezed right by him. What a way to start. Good break for the Sabres, bad one for the Bruins.
Hannon gets the goal and give an unofficial assist to Andy Moog. LaFontaine stopped the line. Airy up there, and the puck is squirted out offside, called in the Buffalo Sabres. And you talk about bounces and breaks and what a huge factor that can be in the postseason. I mean, talk about something to give you a nice jump start, some momentum in opposition ice.
That's exactly what we saw Dave Hannon doing, jumping. And that might just be the start for the Buffalo Sabres. They've got a feel coming out of the season that they just haven't had things going for them, obviously. So they look for any type of positives they possibly can. That might just have been one, killing off the penalty and picking up a goal.
That was not a shorthanded goal, by the way. Time had just expired in the Buffalo power play. Here's Keith Kearney. Over to Bodger. Leach watching him. Patterson. Double team, but he gets the puck up towards center. Leach with it now. Taking a look. Bartlenov breaking for the front of the net. Leach looking for Bartlenov there at the side. He's tied up. Leach takes the scenic route all the way around and tried to get it back to Roberts, but Roberts has to chase it down back in his own end. Weimer. Up along the boards, Bodger flips it right back in for the Sabres. 16:40 to go, first period, 1-0. Buffalo leading on a gift goal. Andy Moog gave the puck away to Dave Hannon, who tucked it into a wide open net. Bartlenov up for Leach, chopped away from him by Patterson. This is Weimer now. And play is called, an elbowing penalty coming up. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs on the NHL tonight.
It's uniquely refreshing.
Himeliev was parked right down in front, looking to redirect it or pick up a loose puck.
Not much surprise, is there, that Pat LaFontaine is leading in points on the power play, but Dale Howardchuk has been very active in that role as well. Alexander Mogilny's 27 goals, however, leads the power play for the Sabres. One key to the Sabres right now in this series is they've got to move that puck around very quickly when they do get power play opportunities. Sabres have had a good jump in this game tonight, though. They're skating. They're very quick when they're moving the puck. They know they have to do that in this building against the Bruins, in their building as well, of course.
Talk about Dale Howardchuk. As per usual, he's back at the right point for the power play. Over there, cutting off the puck now. Howardchuk tried to fire it in. Gets an unfriendly bounce off the skates of Adam Oates. 1:15 to go in the power play for the Sabres. And Buffalo leading 1-0. Dave Hannon with the goal at the 2:32 mark. Here comes Howardchuk across for Mogilny. Himeliev after it down, number 13 for the Sabres. Sweeney knocks it away. Bodger charging up, couldn't keep it in. 55 seconds to go on the man advantage for Buffalo. And the Bruins will make a quick change in the fly with Howardchuk back to fetch.
Bodger's good at shooting the puck from the point, and he likes to pinch in, but he's not great at rushing the puck on the power play.
Mogilny to Odette, trying to sneak in the side, forced to the outside. Here's Holder, all the way across to Howardchuk. Didn't have a shot. LaFontaine. Odette looking for it. Howardchuk will move in from the point. Back to Mogilny. Shooting it. Big play there as Hines slid across. And the Bruins will finally carry it out. This is Donato coming back. He's got Hines with him. Donato, right in. Great work by Donato.
Well, Brian Sutter's got lots of people on the bench that he can go to. Donato's just one of those forwards that he can go to that he knows he's going
Banner
to get a good
planted
solid
in blood
effort
falls.
Out of. Hines was right there looking for a rebound. Grant Fuhr wasn't about to give one up.
Yeah. Sutter just in his element at this time of the year.
What a stretch they had. 14 wins, no losses, no ties in the Adams division. No other team in the National Hockey League had as good a record against their own division as did the Boston Bruins. They were just awesome in the Adams division.
Moore shoots. Fuhr stared him down that time. Ledyard. Sutton trying to come up to May. Back to Grant Ledyard. Oates up there pursuing him. Here's Sutton. Juno almost took it away. Ledyard with May breaking up the middle. Ledyard will carry. Now he dishes off to May coming in. Sweeney trying to break in there. Here's Sweeney. Down low with May breaking for the front of the net. This is Brad May down in the corner. He's pulled down. Sweeney up there after it. Finally, it's knocked away by Weimer. Roberts up there with Neely. And Neely will charge into the corner against Sutton. He bucks him along the boards. Ledyard to May. And May will just dump it off. John Muckler wanted to make some changes. Hannon watching Neely there along the boards. Oates. Juno. Hannon knocks that down. Oates tripped him. And then looked sympathetically towards the referee, hoping for a call. Here's Presley. Hannon. Presley knocks it down, looking for someone in front. Hannon sneaking into the slot. There's Botcher shooting one in. Moog, no problem stopping that chest-high blast. Cam Neely to Shaw. And that will ricochet off the blocker of Fuhr up into the crowd. We'll return to this Molson Canadian Hockey Telecast right after this.
Time for a quick update. Patrick Semmy, Landover, Maryland. Washington mistake, Islander goal. And here it is, Ray Ferraro using Benoit Hogue as a decoy to beat Rick Tabarachi in close. 1-0, the Islanders have the lead on the Capitals. It's early in the first, Paul.
Thanks, John. John Wells, Bob McKenzie watching all the other playoff action throughout the playoffs in TSN.
Here's where Brian Sutter's last line change right now is an advantage to him. LaFontaine's line's out on the ice, and that brings Davey Poulin, the checker for Brian Sutter that played in all 84 games this season. And what a good season Dave Poulin had.
Well, let's see how quickly John Muckler tries to change things up to get LaFontaine away from the people he doesn't want them anywhere near, and that is the Bruins' big one.
The real advantage is when you have that line change and it's in the defensive zone. The Sabres are back taking the draw.
Here comes Peter Juras on the move. Trying to cut to the outside. Carney had him lined up, and they collide down the corner. Delayed penalty coming up. And it's going to be an elbowing call. So the Bruins with another chance in the power play. Bob Airey heading off.
Bob Airey coming across from the Pittsburgh Penguins. Or Mike Ramsey. Bob Airey said, sure didn't get a lot of ice time when you play on a team with as much talent as the Pittsburgh
Ray
Penguins.
Ray Batiss invites you to join Blood Falls.
Duras was heading in to the corner, and you could see Airey just come across your screen and get a piece of Peter Duras, but with the elbow.
Well, Keith Carney kind of had Duras squeezed to the outside and teed him up nicely there for Airey. A little too nicely, evidently. Here's Bork. Gets it back across. Wesley fires it in. Wesley. Neely up there. Juno back along the boards, trying to knock down a loose puck. Bork keeps it in. Shooting it! And that's tipped up over the glass. And then amongst the spectators with 1:42 to go in the power play. Wesley and Bork back there at the blue line. Just poetry to watch them work the power play.
Adam Oates, the big leader for the Boston Bruins on the power play. But Raymond Bork, who didn't have a good first half of the season, but boy, has he come on like gangbusters in the last half of the season. Of course, Joe Juneau, what a rookie season he's had with his club. John Muckler, of course, wanted to try and have his team key in on Raymond Bourque. They felt if they could get on Bourque early in this series, then they might wear him down a bit. Obviously, a good strategy, but one that's difficult to do. Raymond Bourque's used to a lot of ice time, and he also can take the heavy going.
And as much as you talk about the big offensive numbers, which so many people tend to dwell on when you talk about Raymond Bourque, his coach, Brian Sutter, says unquestionably Bourque is at his best when the other team has the puck, not when the Bruins have it. Bourque trying to move it across. Hannon got a piece of it, but look at that. Bourque keeps it in. Waiting for some help now. Back to Wesley. Shoots. Knocked down in front. Juneau was up there, but he'd overskated the loose puck. Juneau now along the boards. Oates in front for Neely. That's tapped out of harm's way. Oates trying to go back to the slot for Bourque. Here's Juneau. Bodger watching him. Neely down low in front. Wesley to Bourque. To Wesley. Shooting it. Blocked at the defense and quickly flicked out. 55 seconds to go on the power play. Bourque up ahead for Wesley. Ledyard intercepts that. Four seconds to go on the man advantage for Boston. Bruins trailing 1-0. Dave Hannon scoring for Buffalo at 2:32. Here's Shaw. And a slashing call coming up. It is going to go against David Shaw. You got tangled up with Kent Sutton right along the boards.
Kaharski trying to keep a handle on this early. Watch this play. Sutton just gave him a little tap initially, and then the retaliation came back by David Shaw. He got the retaliation penalty for slashing.
So the teams will be at even strength for the next 31 seconds. And then the Buffalo Sabres will go on the power play.
So a little bit more open ice right now, and that's definitely to the advantage of Pat LaFontaine and Alexander Mogilny out on the ice now.
Sutton being batched up there by Smolinski. And here comes LaFontaine. Up to Sutton. Team still at even strength for the next 14 seconds. Smolinski, being watched by Mogilny, tries to pick his pocket. He does. Sutton moving into the slot, but Mogilny couldn't get it to him. Scores! LaFontaine!
Whoa, this has sure quieted the Boston Garden, hasn't it? Pat LaFontaine standing right in front of Andy Moog. But it's Alexander Mogilny that has possession of the puck. Watch this, Mogilny keeps possession of it. A couple of Bruins looking at him, but don't do anything. He just turns and fires the puck towards the net. Let's watch here. Here comes Mogilny right at you, but watch Pat LaFontaine. Once Mogilny turns, there's LaFontaine standing right on top of Andy Moog.
So a negative turned into a positive because initially Mogilny, I think, wanted to get it to Ken Sutton, who was moving in from the point wide open in the slot, but the puck kind of bounced on his stick when he tried to pass it. And Moog's going to hang on to that as LaFontaine goes to the net, literally. That goal coming while the teams were still at even strength, and Buffalo now with a power play for the next minute and 10 seconds. So the bounces going the Sabres' way for sure in this first period, going right back to Dave Hannon's goal at 2:32, and Andy Moog handed him a gift.
Pat LaFontaine was up for this series. He had a good jump before the game tonight. When he was walking in the hallway outside of the dressing room, he just seemed to have that spark, as, of course, he usually does. 53 goals this season, 95 assists. Only one other season did he ever score more goals. That was 54 goals for the New York Islanders one season.
Ray Bourque. Here comes Don Sweeney. That's tipped up over the glass and out of play. with 59 seconds still to go on the power play for the Sabres.
Don Sweeney not happy with his move, but